tell me why I just broke my iron. Literally. Broke it. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to be showing. Today we are going to be sewing bandana shorts. Everyone's really been asking for a sew tutorial on TikTok, so I'm here today with it, and we're about to get into it. I'm actually going to be making one of my custom orders right. I'm actually going to be making one of my custom orders that someone ordered for me on TikTok. She ordered a colorful set, so, you know, she wanted me to do what I do, which is whatever I want, which I love when people say that, you know, let me freestyle. So, yeah. Now, making your own patterns is easier than you think it is. It may look difficult, but you can literally make your own patterns out of clothes you own in your closet. This pattern that I use for my shorts, I made it out of a pair of shorts that I had for a really long time. Unfortunately, I threw them away, so I can't remake it, showing you how I did it using a pair of clothes I already owned. But basically, I'm gonna see if I find them. Okay, so I was not able to find a pair of shorts that I can cut up to make the pattern on camera. But basically, if you wanted to make it where the shorts connect, you cut it along the side, including the crotch on that one piece, and then you use that to make this. I believe I have a video on my TikTok of how I did it when I first put it up. But if you actually need me to show you, just let me know in the comments. It's very easy, but if you don't understand what I'm saying, just let me know. Okay, first thing first. When you're doing this, you have to figure out which two colors will be the front pieces and which two colors will be the back pieces, because they will be two different lengths. The back is always supposed to be longer than the front for obvious reasons. You know, if you have a bigger behind, you know, it gotta fit somewhere. So if you're doing this, remember that, keep that in mind, or both pieces will be the same length and you'll end up, it'll be reversible, that'll be good, but if you have a bigger backside than most of us, you will be struggling to put them things on. Whether or not you choose to iron the bandanas is completely your choice. You don't necessarily have to, but it does, you know, help get out like the creases and stuff, because if you sew over a crease, that crease will stay there. Okay, so these two pieces will be my back pieces, and these two will be my front pieces. Okay, to start off, you're going to want to cut off the perimeter around the bandana, you know, the part that isn't the design. It's not a necessary thing that you have to do, but personally I like doing it just because it makes it blend together better when it's mixing with other colors without having that extra layer that has absolutely nothing on it, if that makes sense. And then once you have that cut out, you're just going to take whatever pattern you made or whatever you have to make the shorts. You're going to cut it out. Remember to make the back sides longer than the front. I'll show you what I mean by that, but just keep that in mind. Okay, so this is basically what I mean by making the back side longer than the front. The pink would represent what would be in the back of the shorts, and the orange would represent the front of the shorts. And as you can see, I cut it to where it's a little bit longer on that side. She did ask me to add my own little bit of creativity to her, you know, set, so I will be doing that in this video. You can completely skip over this part if you do not want to learn how to do it. It's basically kind of the easiest way to do patchwork, if there is any other way. This is the way I know. So, yeah, you can skip over this part.
Okay, so for the type of patchwork that I'm doing in this video, you will want to put the two pieces that's meant to be the front of the shorts together and the two pieces that's meant to be at the back of the shorts together. And you're going to want to pin it where the curve is. That way you don't lose it and it stays together and it stays even. And that actually helps when it comes to pinning the pieces together, as you will see as it starts to come along. It makes it a whole lot easier than to cut where that is because it's a curve. It's a little bit harder to sew and this is meant to be easy. So yeah. Now for this, I wouldn't say how you cut the lines really matter, but I would say not to make them too small and too big on two different pieces, because that way when you start to mismatch them together, one is going to come out smaller than the other and one might come out bigger. So it's always best to try to watch out how you cut it out. It doesn't have to be perfect slices, but as long as they're compatible with each other in size, then it all come together the way you like it. Now for this part, I just pinned the pieces together, making sure that it was four on each side, not counting the front piece where the curve is. You're gonna wanna remember that. That's also a good thing to remember when you're cutting out the pieces, is how many you cut out minus the front curve, because that's how many you'll need on each, so you won't have an uneven number on one. When I sewed the pieces together, I just basically sewed in a straight stitch, and you're just gonna place it flat down on the side exactly where you pinned it at, and then you just sew straight down. It's really simple.
This one ends up looking at me in the inside. This one looks like on the outside. Now, this part, I would say you would definitely need an iron, because if you don't iron it out, it end up staying like this, looking kind of puffy on the sides. But once you iron it out, it'll all look flat, like the material was made like that. Including this, you're gonna wanna press down on the seams, so everything lays smoothly. You won't be able to see any of this because I do add a lining fabric, but that's basically all I want to say. You know, if you do decide to do any type of patchwork, I would definitely recommend using an iron after, just to make sure that everything looks a whole lot nicer and flatter. So yeah.
Now personally for me, when it comes to ironing out the seams, I like to hold the two pieces that are overlapping apart with my fingers and I just press down as hard as I can, if that makes sense. If you watch most of my videos, you've seen me use this as a lining fabric before. I get it from Walmart. It's about $3.99 for 1.5 yards, and it works pretty well. It's lightweight and it's really soft. Since I didn't really record it, but you would put the two pieces that are supposed to be the back and the front together, and you would have them facing inside out, and then you would place the lining fabric over it and you would pin it on the sides. But if that does not make sense, like I always say, just let me know in the comments and I'll explain it in a better way. Well, in the best way I can, most likely. For this part, I used a zigzag stitch, but you can really use whatever stitch you choose to. I would suggest a zigzag stitch just because they are shorts and it's less likely to rip this way. And of course, once you have it all sewn up, you're gonna wanna cut off all the excess fabric unless you're using a serger. I wish I had a serger. Trust and believe me, I am getting one, because this can be a little time consuming, especially if you're a perfectionist like I am when it comes to this. So yeah. Now for this part, when it comes to making the waistband, you're basically just gonna fold it over. I personally don't measure it because I know how much space that I need in between, but you can if you have to. Just make sure that it's not too low if you don't want them too short. And once you have it pinned down to your desired length, you're just gonna sew straight across using a straight stitch, making sure to leave an opening for where the elastic can go through. I don't know the proper term for it, so I'm just gonna call it a double waistband because that's what I say. And you would just sew straight across in the middle as even as you can, and then you'd put the elastic through both. So make sure you also leave an opening at the top for the elastic to go through for this part. Now when it comes to feeding the elastic through, you're just going to take the biggest safety pin that you have. It really does make a difference to use the bigger ones because the smaller ones can kind of get lost a little bit easier. Then you're just going to feed it through. Because this is a double waistband, you will want to start with the top first if you choose to do it. And also make sure it doesn't bunch up as you're doing it. Make sure you keep it as open as possible. That way, when it comes time to sew the two pieces of the elastic together, you know that the shorts are not going to be too tight around the waist. And once you're all done, this is what your waistband should look like. Personally, for this part, when you go to close up the hole where the elastic had to go through, I like to use my custom tags, but you do not have to do that if you don't have any. You can just fold it over and sew it straight across. And last but not least, sewing the bottom of the shorts is probably the easiest part for me personally. All you have to do is fold it over, making sure that everything is even on both sides, so one side is not lower than the other, and then you just sew across it in a straight stitch. There's nothing more to it. It's literally just that, the easiest part in the process, the funnest part to me personally. And I almost forgot to mention, when you're doing this, make sure that when you fold it over that the front is shorter than the back. You can tell the front and the back from the shorts is if you look at the crotch area. The crotch area usually sticks up more for the front and it sticks down less going straight down in the back, if that makes sense. But if you look at it in the video and also in your own shorts when you do it, you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. Okay, and this is the final result. These are extra small for anyone wondering, and this is how they came out looking. I did more of a distressed look in the front, as you can see. That's why some of the colors are kind of like on the wrong side. I wanted a distressed look, and this is basically how it came out. I like it. I hope you like it, and I cannot wait to see all the shorts that people make. And so yeah, like and subscribe to my channel, and if you made it this far, thank you for watching my first video.